Thanks for watching. I'm meteorologist Jacqueline Thomas. Heading to the end of our week, of course, all eyes have been on a system that is going to bring some snow. We do have a winter storm warning in effect for Rockingham County here in pink, and that's where we're expecting the highest snowfall totals out of this system. But you're still going to encounter messy roads across most of New Hampshire, especially for the morning commute on Friday. And a winter weather advisory here in this purple shade is also in effect through the day tomorrow. So keep that in mind. Have the snow brushes, the snow shovels ready. The good news is it should be a light and fluffy type of snow as opposed to that heavy and wet snow. So that makes cleanup just a little bit easier. Satellite and radar has been pretty quiet through Thursday, but we have the system to our south and west. That's what's going to be tracking towards us and bringing us the snowfall, and it arrives overnight into Friday morning. So the timeline through Friday, you'll notice these impact icons here, because you're going to encounter slick roadways through the morning, and then the afternoon we'll start to see that snow tapering off a little bit, and I expect some improvements certainly by the evening. So as far as any potential travel impacts or effects you may see if you have to head out and about, no impacts expected through the night until the early morning hours Friday. So the morning commute Friday, you're going to have a high impact with this snow. There'll already be snow on the ground by the time you're heading out 6, 7 a.m. And then as we head into the afternoon, the snow tapers off, but you'll likely still encounter some slick conditions and then continued improvements towards the evening once that cleanup really gets underway. So here's a look at that timeline. Through the overnight hours, we're seeing the clouds thicken up ahead of this system, and then snow showers start to come down by 2, 3 o'clock in the morning. Southern New Hampshire, Keene, Jaffrey, you're likely looking at some snow showers by about 2, 3 o'clock in the morning or so. And then this is going to overspread New Hampshire from south to north as we head through the morning. Here's 7 a.m. Notice how steady this snow is across most of the state. In fact, as you head further north, Coos County and north of the mountains, that's where you're likely going to see less from this system. You're likely going to see just a couple of inches, if that, because of how this is tracking. Also notice the darker shades of this bluish purple color. That's going to indicate some of the heavier snowfall, right? And that's hugging the seacoast, and that's where we had that winter storm warning I just showed you for Rockingham County, because that is where we are expecting the highest snowfall totals. Here's 10 a.m. So by mid-morning, you start to see a little bit of that weakening, a little bit of that lightening up in the snowfall rates in western parts of the state. But notice as you head east towards Rochester, you'll still be looking at a steady snow through mid-morning. And then by the afternoon, this really starts to break apart. So 1, 2 o'clock, you'll notice the steady snow starting to wind down. Lingering snow showers still possible across the state in the afternoon, and I do expect that the mountains will get a lingering snow shower into the evening as this system moves away. We will start to see the clouds breaking up a little bit as we head through Friday evening. And of course, once that snow stops falling, it's going to be easier for cleanup and to make things a little more travelable and not have to worry about the snow covered roadways. And certainly, I think by Friday evening, it's going to be much easier to get around than the morning. So morning commute, biggest issue. By the afternoon and evening, there will be improvements. Friday night, you're going to see that snow ending, but you're also going to see the winds picking up. So here's what we've got. Snowfall forecast, highest amounts expected where I was showing you those darker shades of that blue purple color, and here this purple indicating the highest snowfall total. So 4 to 7 inches possible as you head closest to the seacoast and back through parts of Rockingham County, and then 3 to 5 inches expected from Jaffrey back up through Concord and Laconia, Conway, in that 3 to 5 inch range up towards the mountains as well. North of the mountains, and then as you head north and west, that's where you're going to see the least amount of snow from this system, a coating to 1 inch or 2, up to 3 inches in places like Lebanon and as you head towards Plymouth. So that's what you want to prepare for. As we head overnight, low temperatures fall back into the 20s. So again, it is going to be cold enough, the ground is going to be cold enough, that when the snow starts to fall, it's going to stick pretty quickly. It's not going to take long to see that accumulation starting to pile up. Snow showers will begin in the south and eventually track northward as we head through the early morning hours. So during the day Friday tomorrow, temperatures struggle to really hit that freezing mark. It's going to be cold enough to support snow as the precipitation type. So we're not really talking about mixing for this event. A nice change from some of the recent conditions we had seen. And so it is going to be an all snow type of event, but it is going to be messy in the morning. And then the gusts pick up a little bit as this system starts to move away. Could see gusts to 25 miles per hour, 30 miles per hour as we head through Friday night, overnight into Saturday. Beyond this system, what can we expect? Well, through the weekend, Saturday looks good. It is going to be a little chilly, a little breezy, but we are going to see sunshine Saturday and it should stay dry. And then Sunday, we have a chance for some mixing across the area. So Sunday could get a little bit messy as we head through the afternoon and evening. Rest of the 7-day forecast beyond the weekend, we're talking about a big cool down, a big shot of cold air, an Arctic blast, really, as we head into next week. You'll notice a big difference in those temperatures. Sunday, a little bit of that mixing, temperatures in the 30s. And then not only are the highs going to get cold next week, but look at those lows. Tuesday, Wednesday, we're talking single digits early in the morning, and a lot of spots Wednesday morning could see temperatures below zero.